Good evening, everyone, and welcome to St. Barbara Greek Orthodox Church. It is our pleasure to welcome you here this evening as we prepare to celebrate the evening Vespers service. We have the distinct honor and privilege of welcoming Dr. Grammenos, Karanos from Hellenic College, Holy Cross Greek Orthodox School and Theology in Brookline, together with many of his students and one or two graduates who will be leading us in the prayerful hymns of this evening's service. This is an event that Bringing Them Down is co-sponsored by the Yale Institute of Sacred Music, and we are honored to have Dr. Martin Jean with us, who I will ask to come forward and introduce Dr. Peter Jeffery for just some opening remarks regarding hymnology in the Orthodox Church. Again, this is not a concert, this is a prayer service, so at the conclusion, it would not be appropriate to applaud. It would be appropriate to pray during the service. And afterwards, we will open up for any questions that people may have, and we'll provide an opportunity downstairs for some fellowship and an opportunity to get to know many of the students a little bit better.
Thank you, Father Peter, and thanks to all of you members here at St. Barbara's. It's a real honor to be a partner in this event and to be welcomed into your prayer this evening, and a very warm welcome, of course, to the choir from Holy Cross. We're simply a catalyst here experience and to learn about this rich tradition of Byzantine music that we get to experience very seldom in this part of the world. And the Institute's mission, of course, is to virtually all manner of sacred musics all around the world, a particular interest, of course, in the Christian traditions, and a growing interest in the traditions of the East, the so-called Christian East. Peter Jeffery, who now will turn to just give us some background and some remarks on what we're about to hear and see and experience, is a fellow at the Institute this year. Peter's no stranger to us, however. His wife, Margot Fasser, was my predecessor as director of the Institute. She was director for 10.5 years. Peter himself was a professor of music at Princeton University, where he had earlier received his PhD. He was a MacArthur Fellow for 5 years, some years ago, taught at University of Delaware, and he's now the Michael P. Grace Chair in Medieval Studies at Notre Dame University, where he also teaches theology and music and anthropology. Peter is one of the world experts in Byzantine music and liturgy, and his bibliography of authored articles and books is about as tall as this beautiful nave. I encourage you to get to know his work if that's of interest to you, but now I'll simply turn it over to him for remarks on today's prayer. Thank you.
Thank you. Pick up this handout that you have. And starting on page 2 is the actual Vespers service that we're going to have. The first big thing is Psalm 103 in the Greek numbering, which is Psalm 104 in the Hebrew numbering. It's quite a long psalm. It was originally a kind of a preface to Vespers, and then became an official part of it. And the reason why this particular psalm, if you go to page 4, where it says, "and again," those are verses from Psalm 103 that are particularly significant for the evening. It's the sun knows it's going down, you make darkness and it is night. How manifold are your works? So it's because that psalm mentions night in that way is why it became the introduction to Vespers. Then we have what's called the Great Litany, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, the people say over and over again. That leads up to a prayer by the priest. In the Byzantine rite or the Orthodox liturgy, often when the priest says a prayer, there's a litany in front of it, led by a deacon and with responses by the people. The response is usually Kyrie eleison. So then when we get to page 6, and it says the evening psalm, Psalm 140, that was the original beginning of Vespers, and that is musically a very important part. There's a lot of music for Psalm 140, so it's one of the musical high points of the Vespers. And why Psalm 140? You can tell that from the second verse where it says, let my prayer rise up as incense before you and lifting of my hands as an evening sacrifice. So because it's about evening prayer, it became the major psalm for the Vespers service. So moving right along to page 8, we have what are called the resurrection verses. And these are being sung because it's Sunday. In the Orthodox Church, the Sunday begins on Saturday night, so Saturday night Vespers is actually the beginning of Sunday. And I should mention that the way we're doing it tonight, the men will be singing in Greek and the women will be singing in English. So some things you're going to hear twice, Greek and English, in alternation. Then on page 9 we have hymns in honor of Saint Mary of Egypt, who comes in at this point of Lent, and also today is her feast day. And her story is told on the first page. She's the great saint for repentance in the Orthodox Church. She has the role that Mary Magdalene has in the Western Church. And there's quite a few of those verses. Then on page 11, it says, priest and people, we have this hymn, O joyful light, holy glory of the immortal Father. That is the earliest Christian hymn that is still in use. We don't know exactly how old it is, but St. Basil in the 4th century said that even then it was so old that nobody knew who wrote it. So it's a very early Christian hymn, and like many early Christian hymns, its theme is Christ as the light of the world. So it's an appropriate thing to sing just when evening is coming and people are lighting the lamps for nighttime. Then the next, there's more litanies, including one, instead of Kyrie eleison, the response is grant this, O Lord. Prayers for all the people in the world, all the various kinds of people, and ending with a prayer by the priest. Then on page 16, we have hymns especially about the cross and the resurrection, because this is Lent and because this is Sunday. Finally, on page 17, towards the... before the middle of page 17, we have a Theotokion, a hymn to the Virgin Mary. It's common in the Orthodox liturgy that when you have a series of hymns, the last one is dedicated to the Virgin Mary, so that's a case of that. Then after that, we have the priest says, Lord, now let your servant depart in peace. This is the canticle of Simeon that he sings when he sees the infant Messiah brought into the temple in the Gospel of Luke. It's known in the West as Nunc Dimittis, and since it's about parting in peace, for our eyes have seen the light of salvation, that makes it an appropriate evening hymn. So it's used both in East and West as an evening hymn. After that is the Trisagion, the well-known Eastern Christian chant, Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal. Then on page 18, we have the apolitikia, the dismissal hymns. That means we're moving towards the end, and we're doing a final set of hymns, one about the resurrection, one about St. Mary of Egypt, another Theotokion. Then we finally have the blessings that will actually end Vespers. The Orthodox Church has 8 musical modes, just as the Western Church does, but they're different. They're numbered differently. And in the East, unlike the West, every mode is tuned differently. So most of them cannot be played on a piano keyboard because the tuning isn't the same. The practice is to go through the cycle of one mode per week in numerical order, and this happens to be the week of mode 8, also known as plagal 4. So a lot of the hymns are in plagal 4th mode. And if you know Western music, you can think of that as sort of like a C scale with a B flat. But the pitches aren't exactly the same. When you have the second mode, there's a few hymns in the second mode and the second plagal mode. That's the one that seems most exotic from a Western perspective because it has a very small interval and a very large interval and then a very small interval again, like D, E flat, F sharp, G. So if you listen for da da, da da, the big space in between. That's the second mode, the so-called chromatic type of mode. And I think I've said enough, and I should sit down. There'll be opportunities for questions when it's over. Thank you.
Ευλογητός ο Θεός ημών πάντοτε, νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Come, let us worship and bow down before God our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ our God and King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Him, Christ our King and God. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O Lord my God, you are very great. You are clothed with honor and majesty. Who cover yourself with light as with a garment, who stretch out the heavens like a curtain. He lays the beams of his upper chambers in the waters, who makes the clouds his chariot, who walks on the wings of the winds, who makes his angel spirits, his ministers a flame of fire. You who laid the foundations of the earth so that it should not be moved forever. You covered it with the deep as with a garment. The waters stood above the mountains. At your rebuke they fled, at the voice of your thunder they hastened away. They went up over the mountains, they went down into the valleys, to the place which you founded for them. You have set a boundary that they may not pass over, that they may not return to cover the earth. He sends the springs into the valleys, they flow among the hills. They give drink to every beast of the field, the wild donkeys quench their thirst. By them the birds of the heavens have their home, they sing among the branches. He waters the hills from his upper chambers, the earth is satisfied with the fruit of your works. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle and vegetation for the service of men, that he may bring forth food from the earth and wine that makes glad the heart of man, oil to make his face shine and bread which strengthens man's heart. The trees of the Lord are full of sap, the cedars of Lebanon which he planted. Where the birds make their nest, the stork has her home in the fir trees. The high hills are for the wild goats, the cliffs are a refuge for the rock badgers. He appointed the moon for seasons, the sun knows is going down. You make darkness and it is night, in which all the beasts of the forest creep about. The young lions roaring after their prey and seeking their food from God. When the sun rises, they gather together and lie down in their dens. Man goes out to his work and to his labor unto the evening. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your possessions, this great and wide sea, in which are innumerable teeming things, living both small and great. There the ships sail about, there is that Leviathan which you have made to play there. These all wait for you, that you may give them their food in due season. What you give them, they gather in. You open your hand, they are filled with good. You hide your face, they are troubled. You take away their breath, they die and return to their dust. You send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He looks on the earth and it trembles. He toucheth the hills and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have my being. May my meditation be sweet to him. I will be glad in the Lord. May sinners be consumed from the earth and the wicked be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Praise the Lord. The sun knows it's going down. You made a darkness and it is night. Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Our hope, O Lord, glory to you.
En irini tu Kyrio deithomen. Υπέ της ανωθρηρήνης και της σωτηρίας των ψυχών ημών του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. Υπέ της ειρήνης του σύμπαντος κόσμου, ευσταθίας των Αγίων του Θεού Εκκλησιών και της των Πάντρεν Όσεως του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. Υπέ του Άγιου οίκου τούτου και μεταπίστεως ευλαβίας και φόβου Θεού ησιόντων εν αυτό του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Υπέ του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Δημητρίου του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτέριου της εν Χριστώ διακονίας πάντως το κλήρο και του λαού του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For our country, the President, and all those in public service, let us pray to the Lord. For this parish and city, for every city and country, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth and temperate seasons, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Ότι πρέπει η πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκυνήσεις το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Σιγαρεθέξω πρόσφυγε Christis, Kyrie, Kyrie, nisi postisete. Ότι παρασύ ο ύλας μας αστεί.
Την εκ νεκρών σου Ανάσταση, δοξολογούμεν Χριστέ, δις ηλευθέρωσας αδαμιαίων γένος εκ της του άδου τυραννίδος και εδωρεί τον κόσμο ως Θεός, ζωήν αιώνιον και το μέγα έλεος.
Because of your name I have waited for you, O Lord. My soul waited for your word. My soul hoped in the Lord.
Glory to you, O Christ, Savior, only begotten Son of
φυλακής πρωίας μέχρι νυχτός, από φυλακής πρωίας ελπίσα το Ισραήλ επί των Κυριών.
Σε μεν διεκολίεμ της των σεπτών εποκτίας, μολυσμών των προτέρων, το επισυρώμενον μη αντίριον, ιδεσίας θύσης και των συθεόφρων, πεπραγμένον η συνείδησης την προς τα Κρήτωνα, σι επιστροφή ενηργάσατον, εικόνη γαρ προσβλέψασα, της ευλογημένης Θεόπεδος, πάντων καταγνώσαν δεσμάτων σου πανεύει με το πριν, εν παρησία το τίμιον ξύλων προσεκίνησα.
Περί χαρός τους Αγίους, αρετής εφόδιον, σωτηριοδέστατον ένθεν γεγονάς και σφοδρός έδραμες την καλήν πορείον και το ρήθρον εκπεράσασα το Ιορδάνιον, το του βαπτισμού ενδιέτοιμα, προθύμος κατεσχήνος σας και την των παθών αγριότητα, δια πολιτείας η μαύρος σας λεπτίνας σας σαρκός, εν Παρισία αείμνησθεν,
miter taidimata.
For great is his steadfast love toward us, and the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever.
Dwelling in the wilderness, you blotted out every image of the passions from your soul, having in their place instead printed on your soul the sublime godlike form of the holy virtues. And you showed forth to such an extent that you are able to fly across the waters, O Blessed One, elevated above the ground. When you raise your hands up to God in prayer, now, O Blessed Mother, O glorious Saint Mary, as you stand before the Master with confidence, importunely pray for us.
Sophia. Εξ όλης της ψυχής και εξ όλης της θυανίας ημών υπομέν.
Κύριε Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Lord Almighty God of our fathers, we pray to you, hear us and have mercy.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγαλαιό σου δεμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον. Again we pray for all pious Christians.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Εντιδεόμεθα υπέρ του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Δημητρίου και πάσης της εν Χριστώ ημών αδελφότητος. Again we pray for mercy, life, health, salvation, protection, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servants of God, the members of this parish, the council members, contributors, and benefactors of this holy church.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Et ideomethai per to makarion kiai dimon, clitoron tis ies ecclesias taftis, kei per pandon to pronapatsamenon pateron kia delfonimon, ton enthadevse vos kimenon, και πανταχού Ορθοδόξων.
Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον, Κύριε λέησον.
Again we pray for those who bear offerings, those who do good works in this holy and venerable church, those who toil, those who sing, and all here present who await your great and abundant mercy.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
For you are a merciful and loving God, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Grant, Lord, to keep us this evening without sin. Blessed are you, Lord, God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is your name forever. Amen. Lord, let your mercy come upon us, for we have trusted in you. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your commandments. Blessed are you, Master, make me to understand your commandments. Blessed are you, Holy One, enlighten me with your commandments. Lord, your love endures forever. Do not turn away from the work of your hands. To you belong praise, song, and glory. To the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Πληρώσομεν την εισπυρήνην δέησιν ημών το Κύριον.
Κύριον ελέησον.
Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της η χαρητή.
Κύριον
perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless evening, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord. Συγνώμην και άφεσιν των αμαρτιών και των πλημελημάτων ημών παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
Grant this, O Lord.
For all that is good and beneficial to our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask the Lord. For the completion of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For a Christian end to our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good account before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Ότι αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Ειρήνη πάση peace be with all.
Spirit.
Τας κεφαλάς ημών το Κύριο κλεινόμεν, let us bow our heads unto the Lord. Το κράτος της βασιλείας σου ευλογημένων και δεδοξασμένων του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Βασίλευσεν ευπρέπειαν ενεδύσατο Κύριος δύναμιν και περιεζώσατον. Χριστόν δοξολογήσομεν τον Αναστάντα εκ νεκρών. Ψυχήν και σώμα γάραν αλάβων το πάθη απαλήλων διέτεμεν. Της αφράντου μεν ψυχής εν άδη κατελθούσης, ον και σκύλευσε τα φοδέδι αφθόραν ουκ είδε το Άγιον σώμα του λυτρωτού των ψυχών ημών.
And he established the world which shall not be. We glorify your resurrection from the dead, O Christ, in psalms and hymns. For by it you have freed us from the torments of Hades, and have, since you are God, granted us eternal life and great mercy.
Αγίας μα Κύριε, εις μακρότητα ημέρων, ο Δέσποτα των απάντων, ακατάληπτε δι' τα ουρανού και γης, δι' ασταυρού παθών εμή απάθειαν επίγασας, τα φύνδε καταδεξαμένος και αναστάσεν δόξη. Συνανέστησας τον Άδαμ, Κύρι παντοδυνάμω. Δόξα τη τριήμερο εγένση, της δεδόρισε ημίν την αιώνιον ζωήν και ηλασμόν αμαρτίον ως μόνος εσφαγνός.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Πνεύμα.
νυχτέρα ανεφανδρών τετοκίαν και έναν γάλες φέρουσαν τον άπασαν την κτήσιν περιέχοντα Θεού εστί βουλή το κήθεν όνος βρέφος φώναγνεν σαν σολένες βαστάσασαν και μητρικήν παρησίαν προς αυτόν και κτημένην μη πάση δισοπούσα υπέρ των σε τιμόντων το εκτηρήσε και σώσε τα συχάσιμο.
Απολύς των δούλων σου δέσποτα κατά το ρήμα σου εν ειρήνη, ότι είδον οι οφθαλμοί μου το σωτηριόν σου, ο ετοίμασες κατά πρόσωπον πάντων των λαών, φως εις αποκάλυψην εθνών και δόξων λαού σου Ισραήλ.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς. Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς. Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι, και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Παναγία Τριάς ελέησον ημάς, Κύριε ηλάς τες αμαρτίες ημών, Δέσποτα συγχώρησον τας ανομίας ημήν. Άγιε επίσκεψε και ίασε τας ασθενίας ημών, ένεκεν το ονόματός σου. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι, και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Πάτερ ημών, ο εν της ουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης, των άρτων ημών των επιούσιων, δώσι μην σήμερον και άφεσι μην τα οφείληματά ημών, ως και εμείς αφίεμεν τους οφειλέτες ημών, και μη εν έγκυση μας εις πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσε ημάς από του πονηρού.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Thank you.
και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ο Δήμος γεννήθης εκ Παρθένου και σταυρώσιν
Σημών πάντοτε νυν και άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Στερεώσε Κύριος ο Θεός την Αγίαν και αμόμητον πίστην των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών, σι τη Αγία αυτού Εκκλησία και την πόλη ταύτη εις αιώνας αιώνων. Αμήν.
Glory to you, Christ our God, and our hope, glory to you.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίου Πνεύματι και νυν και άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πατέρ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
May Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, as a good, loving, and merciful God, have mercy upon us and save us. Through the intercessions of his most pure and holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable, glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, the holy, glorious, and praiseworthy apostles, the holy, glorious, and triumphant martyrs, our righteous and God-bearing fathers, Mary, of all and save us, for he is good and loves humankind. Διευκόντων Άγιον Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. Once again, I thank you for joining us for the celebration of Great Vespers. And in a few moments, everyone is invited to join us downstairs now that we have received spiritual nourishment for some physical nourishment as well, and for the opportunity to be able to continue in the conversation that we began earlier. I'm not sure if there are questions that you wish to pose, but I will certainly invite many of us to answer any that anyone has. And if there are none, or people are shy.
I didn't hear the question.
Why are the notes 7 or 8 and not?
That's so the question was, why are there 8 modes, not 7 or 6, or, and that's a very difficult question to answer, and probably Dr. Jeffery knows better than me. It might be related to the fact, to a lot of facts actually. One, maybe the ancient Semitic way of counting time. It seems like instead of the 30-day month, they had a 50-day month. So this was adopted by the church. And then the church made 8-week cycles in which to perform the hymnology. Another reason might be the ancient Greek fascination with the number 8 as a perfect number, the Pythagorean number 8. And in Christian theology, eight plays an important role as well. It is known, or it is seen as the number of infinity, the number of God. And a final reason might be the fact that in most musical cultures, if we go up the scale, usually we find eight notes. So each of these notes became the bass or the tonic of each of the eight modes in the medieval times. Dr. Jeffery may have a better answer.
Actually, until quite recently, we couldn't tell you very much about how it started as a musical phenomenon. It is true that there's a calendric aspect that some of the church fathers talked about Sunday as the eighth day that goes beyond the 7 days of the week, and the eighth day is kind of a foretaste of eternity as the day that Christ rose from the dead. So there's the calendric aspect. And it is true that in many cultures, there's about eight notes to the octave. So all these things are true. But in recent years, we've discovered the actual origin, which is this. In the church in Jerusalem, on every Sunday morning, there was a vigil in front of the actual tomb of Christ, the same tomb that Christians worship now in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. In the old basilica that was there, that was built by Constantine, there was this practice of having a resurrection vigil every Sunday morning, and the bishop would read one of the accounts from the would stand in front of the tomb and read one of the accounts from the resurrection. And before that, they would sing three psalms for the 3 days, and so on. And it was there that the custom developed, because there were four gospels, the resurrection stories were divided into two, so that there was a series of eight readings from the gospels. And they developed the practice of singing a hymn after each gospel and starting on a different note each week. And so they went through all eight notes, and that became the origin of the eight modes. Subsequent to that, the Orthodox, the Byzantine Rite or Orthodox morning service on Sunday has divided the Gospels further, so that now there are 11. But the basic custom goes back to Jerusalem, to this time when they had a sequence of eight Gospels with a musical mode developed for each one. And that was the actual origin of it. Although the musical phenomena, the calendric phenomena, and so on, those are all part of it too.
I do not really have a good answer for that. It's the style that developed. Yes, Father. Oh, yes, the question was, why do we sing from the throat and not from the diaphragm? We do not really sing from the throat, actually, but it's the style that was developed primarily in Constantinople, in the Ecumenical Patriarchate, and the way we perform today might be related to the vocal style of Oriental music. Yes. It's possibly related, and again, Dr. Jeffery might have a better answer for you for this one, but it's possibly related to the fact that the services, the way they're done today, come from two different sources, two different rites, the cathedral rite and the monastic rite. The cathedral rite was primarily sung, the monastic rite was primarily read, so today we have elements of both in one. I don't know if you have a... In fact, in more festal Vespers, Psalm 103 or part of Psalm 103 is chanted. Yes. I have no knowledge of that. That's.
I'm not sure I understand the question, because every building would be acoustically somewhat different. So a hymn. Sorry? Well, I don't know of, if you mean something like they paused and waited for the reverb to die down and then they continued, is that what you're implying? Well, I don't know how you would prove that that was the reason. But I will say that in the Byzantine churches, there was a lot of interest in the reverb, and many churches in Eastern countries, many medieval churches, have sort of clay pots that are buried in the wall that sort of act as resonators. And in some places where the wall has deteriorated, you can actually see them. And so there was a deliberate attempt to increase the echo and the resonance in a lot of these buildings. But there isn't a case I can point to where I can say this guy wrote this hymn with reverb in mind, you know. Well, I would say that's an oversimplification. In modern Western music, we have two modes, which are major and minor. But in medieval and Renaissance Western music, we had eight modes, some of which sound major, some of which sound minor. But the eight Byzantine modes, because every mode is tuned differently, it's actually more complicated. And some of them, even the ones that are sort of like major, are not really tuned the same way for the most part. The ones that come the closest are the third mode and the third mode plagal, which are a lot like the scale on F on the piano. So those two would be major. The others, it's not that they're not major, it's just that they're tuned in a different way, so that the pitches aren't, you know, on a piano, every key is exactly the same distance apart from the next key. And in the Byzantine tunings, that's not true. Some pitches are farther away than others.
And just to add to that, Byzantine intervals are not static. In other words, usually you have the tetrachord, a series of four consecutive notes, and the bottom note and the upper note are very stable. They function like poles of attraction. And the intermediate notes are moving upwards when the melodic line moves upwards, or downwards when the melodic line moves downwards. So the intervallic landscape changes all the time. They are very fluid. Again, a different concept, very different way of looking at a scale than what we're used to in the West. Yes?
Is there any spiritual
primarily it's tonal stability. Yes, yes. Is there any spiritual significance to the drone, the note that you heard hummed by the basses, or do they just are they there for musical purposes? Their primary function is to provide tonal stability. We do not know for a fact when the phenomenon emerged. There is evidence of drone, eson, holding in 14th century manuscripts. I don't know, Dr. Jeffery, if we have anything before that, but it is surmised that the practice may be even older because certain instruments produce a drone, so possibly vocalists just started mimicking that phenomenon. In terms of a spiritual value to it, the late English composer John Tavener said that the eson, the drone, represents eternity. So you have the melodic line moving up and down, away or closer to the bass note, the root, just like the soul is moving away and closer to God. And then at the end, it reaches God when it becomes one with eson. But this is a modern theological or pseudo-theological justification of a clearly musical practice. I don't know if you have anything else to add.
The eson or drone is more part of the practice. It doesn't have a lot of written history. Some books tell you put it on this pitch, but many books do not. The one significance of it is musical, in that there's only certain pitches where you can have the drone, depending on what mode you're in. And in general, it starts on the lower pitch, and then when the melody moves up to the higher part of the mode, then it moves to the upper pitch, and then it moves back down again. The spiritual interpretations, I think, arose after the fact, and were not the cause of it. I think a lot of what started it is in monasteries. In the old days, when books had to be copied by hand, they couldn't give everybody a book, and things were supposed to be performed from memory anyway. So they had a prompter. They had a boy with a book, and he would read the words but not sing the melody. And I think it was his reading that turned into the drone. So he would, he would stand there and read things like, "Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal," without changing the pitch, while the choir would change the pitch. So I think that's the actual origin of it. And it is around the 14th, 15th century that we start to give clues that this is happening. And that's the best we can do, because most manuscripts don't indicate the drone. It's part of the practice.
And it was actually first notated in the 19th century. So before that, we do not have notation of the drone, just indications that it existed as a practice. Did not get it. Oh, we decided to do that to give you a glimpse of the way Byzantine music is performed in major cathedrals in Greece and in women's monastic establishments. So just to give you two different tastes. And also, this reflects a practice at the Holy Cross Chapel. We do not usually do male-female, but it's always antiphonal, so two choirs. Greek and English, and sometimes we have a women's choir on one side, but usually it's mixed. Any other questions?
Thank you. Once again, everyone, please join us downstairs. For those for whom stairs are difficult, there is an elevator that's located right outside this door. There's only one level to go to, and you'll be able to see right there. Also, if you're interested in various CDs that also have various Byzantine chants, including some that were recorded by students from Hellenic College Holy Cross, you can look downstairs in our bookstore. Thank you. Have a blessed evening. As a reminder, tomorrow morning we begin the offer service at 8:30 a.m. and the Divine Liturgy following at 9:45. And the choir will be able to be here, and we'll be here to chant the hymns of the Matins and the Divine Liturgy that follows. Have a blessed evening.
Alexandria.
Alexandria,
that's a good one. Thank you.
It's missing one in Apostrophe.
Yeah.
Yes. We should have father too.